Good afternoon, my name is Joshua Lane. I'm a student physical therapy assistant here at Miami-Dade College. Today, I'm gonna be measuring hip abduction range of motion, and according to the AMA, the normal range for that is 40 degrees. I'm here with my patient, Ernesto. How are you, Ernesto?
Good.
Today, I'm gonna be measuring the ability to move your leg out from this position to up here. Sounds okay?
Yes.
So I need you to lay down supine for me, on your, with your back and your face hitting the ceiling. First thing I do is lay the patient in the starting position, which is supine. Okay, facing the ceiling. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move him through the available passive range of motion. Determine the end feel, which is firm, which is normal. I'm going to make a visual estimate, which I'd say is about 35 degrees. Next, I move him back to the starting position. I'm going to palpate for the anatomical landmarks. I'm looking for the fulcrum is going to go on the ASIS of the affected side. The proximal arm is going to go on an imaginary line across to the other ASIS. And the distal arm goes down parallel to the anterior midline of the femur, okay? So next, I'm going to read and record the starting position, align with the anatomical landmarks, which is zero, that's good. I'm gonna remove the goniometer. I'm gonna move him through the available passive range of motion, and now realign the goniometer with the anatomical landmarks. And it looks to be at 35 degrees, which is a little lower than normal, and that's range of motion for hip abduction.